So, now we have seen a couple of examples like Abraham Lincoln, Lee D. Forrest, Wright Brothers, Colonial Sanders, and also Walt Disney. So, after seeing these examples, we can simply say that success was not so easy for them at a single attempt. In the examples, success easy with a lot of hard work, they have got. Understood? More we will go to see. Successful people do not do great things, they only do small things in a great way. Okay? Successful people will not do any great things. Okay? What they do is they only do small things in a great way. Chinna chinna pannu goppaga ante broad-mindedness toti, they'll think in a broad-mindedness and they will do. Understood? So the broad-mindedness here means that thinking positively. Okay? Though they are failure, they are not quitting. Okay, what is the meaning of thinking positive? Though they are failure, no, they are not quitting. They are trying to analyze the mistakes what they have done there. Again, they shall make the so they make small things in a great way. Understood? Okay, one more example will go. One day, a partially deaf 4-year-old kid came home with a note in his pocket from his teacher. "Your Tommy is too stupid to learn. Get him out of the school." His mother read the note and answered, "My Tommy is not stupid to learn. I'll teach him myself." And the Tommy grew up to be great Thomas Edison. Thomas Edison had only 3 months of formal schooling, and he was partially deaf. Okay, here is one more example, Nana. So, one day a partially deaf boy, okay, vilikiri correct ga ledhu koncham koncham, there is some disturbance in hearing. So the boy, no, he came home from school with a small note in his pocket. So he showed that note to his mother. Note here is a small message in a paper, okay, that he, the teacher, kept in his pocket and sent it him. So the mother, no, she just opened the note. What was written in that is, "Your Tommy is stupid." Here, stupid means not intelligent, cannot able to understand. So, don't send him to school. Then the mother decided, no, she thought to himself that my son is not stupid. I will teach for my son. Okay. Then, like that, he had a schooling only for 4 months. He went to regular school only to the 4 months. Later on, his education he completed with his mother. So this was a great person in his life, that is Thomas Edison. Understood? If the mother was being distracted at that time when the teacher wrote the note, then we would not have such a great scientist, no ma? Yes or no? Yes. Next, we'll go with one more. Henry Ford forgot to put the reverse gear in the first car he made. Okay? Do you consider these people failures? They succeeded in spite of problems, not in the absence of them. But to the outside world, it appears as though they just got lucky. All success stories are also stories of great failures. The only difference is that every time they failed, they bounced back. This is called falling forward rather than backward. You learn and move forward. Learn from your failures and keep moving. Okay, one more example we have got, Anna. See, Henry Ford. Henry Ford is the person who had invented Ford Icar cars. Okay, this person, no, when he had first manufactured the first car, he forgot to put a reverse gear. Okay, so you might be knowing now, when the people make some cars or other things, they exhibit. Okay, whatever the things they manufacture, they exhibit in front of others as a part of promotion. So here when he exhibited, lot of rejections were there, saying that, "Arey, what is this car without a reverse gate?" Then immediately he had rearranged, keeping a reverse gate, and which was a which was success. Yes or no? So as now we have seen lot of examples. Now if you consider these people as failures, right from Abraham Lincoln to Henry Ford, what we have learned. If you think if these are failures, do you think these are failures? No. They all have succeeded in their lives. Though they got some attempts were failures in their lives, but they were success. Yes or no? They have overcome the failures. వాళ్ళకి ఏ ఇబ్బందులు అయితే వచ్చాయో, ఓటమిలు అయితే వచ్చాయో, వాటిని అధిగమించుకొని వచ్చారు. దే హ్యావ్ ఓవర్కమ్ దెమ్. బట్ టు ద అవుట్సైడ్ వరల్డ్ ఇట్ అపియర్స్ నో యాజ్ దే జస్ట్ గాట్ లక్కీ. ఎస్ ఆర్ నో? నో వన్ విల్ సీ హౌ మెనీ అటెంప్ట్స్ దే హ్యావ్ మేడ్ టు గెట్ ద సక్సెస్. సో నాట్ ఓన్లీ దీస్ కపుల్ ఆఫ్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్స్ విచ్ ఆర్ గివెన్ ఇన్ యువర్ టెక్స్ట్ బుక్, if you take more examples of any person, all success stories are also stories of great failures. Only one difference is there. What is that difference? Is every time they failed, they bounced back. Okay, so here bounced back is they recovered, they analyzed their mistakes. ఎప్పుడెప్పుడైతే ఎవరైతే వాళ్ళు ఫెయిల్యూర్ అయ్యారో, దే బౌన్స్డ్ బ్యాక్, దట్ ఈస్ దే హ్యావ్ రికగ్నైజ్డ్ ద మిస్టేక్స్ వాట్ దే హ్యావ్ డన్. సో దిస్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ యాజ్ రెక్టిఫైయింగ్ అండ్ మూవింగ్ ఫార్వర్డ్ బట్ నాట్ బ్యాక్వర్డ్. ఈ బౌన్స్డ్ బ్యాక్ అంటే తెలుసుకోవడం కదన్న, దానంటే ఏంటి, ముందుకు వెళ్ళడం, తప్పులు తెలుసుకొని తప్పులు సరిదిద్దుకొని ముందుకు వెళ్ళడము, నిరాశతోటి వెనకకి కాకుండా. ఓకే, నెక్స్ట్ బిలో. ఓకే, ఇన్ 1914 థామస్ ఎడిసన్ ఎట్ ద ఏజ్ 67 లాస్ట్ హిస్ ఫ్యాక్టరీ విచ్ వాస్ వర్త్ ఎ ఫ్యూ మిలియన్ డాలర్స్ ఆన్ ఫైర్. ఇట్ హ్యాడ్ వెరీ లిటిల్ ఇన్సూరెన్స్. నో లాంగర్ ఎ యంగ్ మ్యాన్ ఎడిసన్ వాచ్డ్ హిస్ లైఫ్ టైమ్ ఎఫర్ట్స్ గాట్ అప్ ఇన్ స్మోక్ అండ్ సెడ్, there is a great value in disaster, all our mistakes are burnt up, thank god we can start anew. In spite of the disaster, 3 weeks later he invented the phonograph. What an attitude. Yes, okay, now see one more example, Nara. It's all about Thomas Edison. In 1914 Thomas Edison, when he was at the age of 67 years, factory was being burnt, okay, which is of millions of dollars worth. Everything was being burnt. So there was only a little insurance for that factory. Generally, after coming to certain position, after having lot of wealth, once everything is lost, we feel very discouraged.